Welcome everyone, my name is Akshaya Kavale. I'm a nature and animal communicator, which means I can have two-way conversations with plants, animals and other species. And continuing on our series on grounding using our senses, in this video I'm going to share with you how we can ground ourselves using the sense of feeling. And this is something that I personally use a lot because my dominant sense is the sense of feeling and also my thoughts. So basically claircognizance and clairsentience. So we are talking here more about clairsentience and how to use grounding with the help of our sense of feeling. Now, for all those of you who are Harry Potter fans or who are fans of fiction fantasies like Peter Pan and others, I'm sure you will know of this technique. It is personally one of my favorites because it involves a lot of daydreaming and imagination, and I like to do that. So what you can do is you can think of one of the happiest moments of your life. It could be something that you have achieved. It could be that one time where everybody gave you a standing ovation in school. It could be that one time when you scored exceptionally well in a subject that you don't do well. It could be just a small surprise that someone has given you, any kind of happy memory. And as you recollect that memory, I request you to feel everything that you had felt in that moment. Don't think too much about it as to how can I feel exactly the same way. It doesn't matter. It could just be you relaying the memory and feeling new emotions, and that's fine. What is important is that it's a happy memory, because you don't want to ground yourself thinking about things that are not making you feel positive or not making you feel happy. Indulge in that thought, indulge in that imagination for as long as you can. It doesn't matter how long it is, honestly. Like I keep saying, it can be a couple of minutes, it can be an hour, it is completely up to you. What is important is that you feel all those emotions, and it helps you to align your energies, and that is how you will be able to ground yourself using your sense of feeling. Another thing you can do with the sense of feeling is taking something in your hand. For example, if I have this remote in my hand, just taking it in your hand and feeling everything about it. So just keep touching it, and you can feel the buttons here, you can feel the shape, the thickness, you can feel this kind of hook over here, so on and so forth. And try to feel everything about the thing in your hand, as well as how it is making you feel, because every touch will make you feel something. Do it for as long as possible. Again, the time is not important, but you focusing on that feeling is important. If you are someone whose dominant sense is feeling, these are two very effective ways of grounding yourself. So if you have tried it, or if you have any other technique that involves your sense of feeling, do mention it in the comment section below. And even if you are not a clairsentient, even if your dominant sense is not the sense of feeling, do experiment with this technique and let me know how it has helped you, and if it didn't help you, what really helps you, because I would love to learn from your experiences. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and found it helpful.